Hi, I'm Dr. Lisa Thompson of drlisaandthompson.com, and in today's video, I'm going to share with you two quick ways to really prune your list so that, number one, you're saving money on your autoresponder fees, and number two, you're going to help build a buyer's list. Now, I learned this two tips from my good friend and mentor and home business expert, Diane Hockman. And so what you need to understand first is when you're looking at your autoresponder, there's different levels of membership. So what happens is as you accumulate more subscribers to your list, then as you're going to be hitting different levels where you have to pay more for the autoresponder to manage your list. So it's really important that at least once a month you go through your list and you remove your unsubscribers. So you'll have people who will unsubscribe from your list. And so what you want to do is you want to remove those people from your list. So here's a real simple way to do that. So what you want to do is choose your list. Now I have quite a few lists on my autoresponder. So you pick a list and you want to do this once a month. So you want to come down and then you want to go to subscribers, click manage subscribers, and then what you want to do is click on the unsubscribed. So when that comes up, you're going to notice that I have 36 unsubscribers. So just because they unsubscribed, that doesn't mean that that they are removed from your list. You have to remove your unsubscribers so they don't get added along with being managed by your autoresponder. So what you want to do is you want to click okay, and then you're going to click delete, and I'm going to click delete, okay, and then I'm going to do that again here, and I'm going to click delete. These people don't want to be on my list, and that's fine. I don't want them on my list. You know, think of this like you're pruning the weeds out of your garden, okay? So you want to go through and get people off of your unsubscribed, and you also want to look at the undeliverables. So if you've got people who are that means that the emails are not getting delivered to these people. They may have put in the wrong email address, or they no longer are using that email account. So you want to delete those as well. Now, what you can also do, too, is if you notice, this is a really great way to get more engagement back into your list, where you can do segments. So what you can do with your subscribers, this is another way to get more people off of your list, is this is just a really cool way, and what Diane taught here too. I'm going to come up to my broadcast, and I'm just going to show you what I did here. I did a favor where I wanted to see about people wanting to be off of my list because there were some people who weren't opening my list. So I'm going to come down and I'll show you the message that I wrote. So what I did, I'll make this a little bit bigger so you guys can see this, is I put down and I said, hello, and you subscribe to my newsletter. Now there's a little personalization you can do on AWeber where you can show them the date they signed up to your list. So I put that date for my newsletter on the signed date, signed up and opted into my list to get a copy of my 17 diabetic snack ideas. And then I said, I have a favor to ask you. If you don't wish to be on this newsletter, you can unsubscribe by going here, and there's another personalization where I had YouTube, or not YouTube, but AWeber put an unsubscribe link. So people can click on that link and be off of my list. And then I put, if you would like to remain on this newsletter, please reply to this email to tell me more of what type of content you would like to see so that I can help serve you better. Thank you. So what that does is now I'm going to get people to re-engage with me with my emails, because people who respond back, they are paying attention. So this is a real important step. It's a very easy and effective step that will help you, okay, get more people to be responding. Because what you want, it's not the size of the list that is going to make you money. It's how responsive your list is going to be. So you want to get rid of that dead weight so that you're keeping You know, Diane does this all the time. You know, she's someone who makes 7 figures a year, and she doesn't have more than, I think, 4,000 people on her email list. But you go through once a month. So let's do a quick recap. Go through once a month, remove those who have unsubscribed from your list, and the undeliverables, where you're, you know, which means they're bouncing from your email list. And then what you can do is you can go in and send a message to your list at least once a month, or, you know, once every couple of months, to see if you can get people to unsubscribe there and get people to re-engage with your list. So I hope this helps you out. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking on the subscribe button you see on the lower right-hand corner of your screen. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.